Hallelujah. Praise be to God. Praise be to our King. We worship you, my Father. We glorify you today. You are so worthy, my God. You are so worthy, my King. This is the day that you've made, that we may rejoice and be glad in it. Welcome everybody, welcome everybody wherever you are from, those are nearby and those who are far off. I want to welcome you to this live cast, to this prophetic prayer moment. I believe God is going to bless you, God is going to lift you, God is going to do that which nobody can do. God is going to make you significant. God is going to give your life a meaning. God is going to raise you higher. God is going to do what he did and what he has never done before. God is going to shower you with his blessing as you get up, as you type that button of share, as you type that button of subscribe, as you type that button of inviting your friends to this live cast, this prophetic prayer moment. We are going to move forward. We are going to tap into the supernatural. We are going to join the presence. God is pouring his presence upon us today. I know his favor is going to speak for you. I know his mercy is going to speak for you. I know his grace is going to speak for you. I know his anointing is going to speak for you. I know his might arm is going to speak for you. This very hour I declare, let the might arm of the Lord speak for you. Let the grace of God speak for you. Let the favor of God be your real God. In the name of the Lord, I am praying that today, let the glory of God speak for you. Let the enemy bow before you at the gate. In the name of Jesus, that plot of the enemy which he had plotted against you, may it be dispatched. May it be broken. In the name of Jesus, the devil that was against your job, the devil that was against your marriage, the devil that was against your children, the devil that was against your spouse, the devil that was against your progress, the devil that was against your finances, the devil that was against your connection, the devil that was against your favor, the devil that was against your uprising, the devil that was against you now, the devil that was against your the progress of your children, he is bowing right now by the power of the Holy Spirit. As we pray, as we declare, as we pray, as we call upon the name of the Lord at this prophetic prayer moment, as you use your hands to share, as you use your hands to invite your friends, as you water others in secret, may God water you in the open. As you make it happen for others, may God make it happen for you. As you make another person happy, may God wipe away every tear of frustration from your eye. In the name of the Lord, may God wipe away every tear that you have ever shed before. In the name of Jesus, I declare today and decree, let the power of God, let the anointing of the Holy Spirit, let the anointing of the Father wipe away those tears, every tears of misery or tears of frustration, every tears of depression. May God wipe it away now. I declare it today. May God wipe away every tear. May God wipe away every tear. That tear, those tears and those wounds which you received from the house of your friend, may God bind them up. I say every wound which you received from the house of your friend, may God bind it up. I declare that today, let every wound which you received from the house of your friend, from the house of your spouse, from the house of someone close to you, those wounds that you received, may God bind them up. I declare that today, by the power of the Holy Spirit, somebody, you are getting delivered. Somebody, you are getting a breakthrough today. Somebody, you are getting a breakthrough today in the name of the Lord. And the Bible declares, and the king did not sleep until he commanded the books of Pentecost be brought before him, the books of remembrance to be brought before him. And he remembered Mordecai and he rewarded him. And he remembered Mordecai and he rewarded him. I am praying today, everybody you helped and they forgot about you, let God bring your name to their mind today. Let you receive a phone call of appreciation. May you receive a message of appreciation. May you receive a gift of appreciation. I am saying today, may God cause them to remember you, those you assisted to make it, those you assisted to fly and they forgot about you, those that you assisted to start a business and they forgot about you, those you assisted to marry and they forgot about you, those that you assisted to give birth and they forgot about you. I am hereby declaring, by the power of the Holy Spirit, let God cause them to open the books of remembrance. Let the books of remembrance be brought before them, be brought before their mind. Let them remember you. I can see somebody calling you and giving you good news. I can see your child being assisted in the name of the Lord. I can see your house being accomplished in the name of the Lord. I can see your house is being accomplished. This I see it now in the spirit. I can see God intervening in your situation. I can see somebody remembering you. Good news is coming. I say good news is coming. I say good news is coming. By the power of the Holy Spirit, there is good news coming in your house. Oh, there is good news coming in your house. You are going to forget what it is to cry the tears of misery. I see God is making you forget to cry the tears of misery. This is what I see now in the name of Jesus. Those tears of misery are ending right now. I said they are ending right now. I can see a promotion. I can see a divine connection. Receive the power of God in the name of the Lord. I say receive the power of God. God is giving you back. God is giving you back whatever you lost to the devil. The Bible declares in the book of Psalm chapter 105, give thanks to the Lord and call upon his name. Come on, give thanks to the Lord. Jonah, give thanks to the Lord. Isaac, give thanks to the Lord. Sherrod, give thanks to the Lord. Caroline, give thanks to the Lord. Evelyn, give thanks to the Lord. Give thanks to the Lord and call upon his name. In the name of the Lord. Oh, give thanks to the Lord. Carol, give thanks to the Lord. In the name of the Lord. Eunice, give thanks to the Lord. Come on, raise up your hands wherever you are. You may be going through tough and thick. You may be going through troubled waters. You may be going through the darkest moments of life. But why don't you get up your hands and give thanks to the Lord? If he has ever done it before, I know he has ever done it for you. If he has ever delivered you before, of which I know he has, he can also deliver you now. He can take you out of this now. He can bless you again. He can heal your body. This is what I declare. You're not going to die on the bed of sickness. You're not going to die in misery. You're not going to die in shame. You're not going to die in cowardice. You're not going to die in fear. In the name of the Lord, I declare that today. I declare that the remaining of this year, you're not going to bar a relative in the name of Jesus. You're not going to be claimed by COVID-19. That I cancel it now. The powers of COVID-19 has no hold on you. By the power of the Holy Spirit, I declare today, every powers of COVID-19 has got no power over you. I disable it now. I render it powerless now. I declare by the power and by the unction of God in the name of Jesus, every powers of the devil has no power over you, has no power over your family, has no power over your children, has no power over your spouse, has no power over your loved ones. In the name of Jesus, I am praying today, let the glory of God be your real God. Even today, I declare today, in the name of the Lord, give thanks to the Lord. And call his name, and call his name. Come on, somebody, call his name. Mayaka, call upon his name. Evelyn, call upon his name. Martin, call upon his name. Oh, call upon his name. Robert, Robert, call upon his name. In the name of the Lord, come on, call upon his name. Mary, Linda, call upon his name. Marcy, call upon his name. Sam, call upon his name. He's able to take you out of this. I says able to take you out of this. Josephine, call upon his name. Dorcas, call upon his name. Tabitha, call upon his name. In the name of the Lord. Leban, call upon his name. Ronnie, call upon his name. Moses, call upon his name. In the name of the Lord. Come on, come on, call upon his name. Mama Chamagero, call upon his name. Yes, call upon his name. He is able to do exceedingly abundantly above beyond what we can think and ask. Come on, call upon his name. He can make a way where there seems to be no way. The God of Isaac is still our God today. The God of Abraham is still our God today. The God of miracles, the God who parted the sea, is still our God today. Come on, call upon his name. Come on, call upon his name. Call upon his name now. In the name of Jesus, proceed, call upon his name. Hey, Tina, call upon his name. In the name of the Lord, come on, call upon his name. He is worthy of the praise. He's worthy of the glory. He's worthy of the honor. Call upon his name and make known among the nations what the Lord has done. Come on and tell a testimony of what the Lord has done for you. Tell the people how the Lord delivered you. Come on, testify on how the Lord our God made you board that plane. Come on, testify how he made a way for you then. Come on, tell the world the good things the Lord has done. Come on, testify. Type a message and testify. Tell what God has done. Come on, everybody watching me. Prudence, tell what God has done. Peace, tell what God has done. In the name of Jesus. Martha, Martha, tell what God has done. Everybody tell what the Lord has done. Type a message today and tell what the Lord has done. He is mighty towards the children of men. He is mighty. His doings are mighty towards the children of men. Our God is mighty. Our God is awesome. Our God is powerful. Our God is gracious. Our God is anointed. Our God has the power. Tell about his works. Tell your neighbors about his works. Come on, share that testimony about what the Lord has done. Come on, share that testimony about what the Lord has done. Your legs are healing now. Your headache is gone now. Your chest is healing now. In the name of Jesus, your lungs are loosing now. In the name of Jesus, your kidney is free, is healing now. In the name of Jesus, your pain in the back is disappearing now. In the name of Jesus, come on, tell what the Lord has done. Come on, tell what the Lord has done. I can see a debt being canceled now. I can see a debt being canceled now. The Lord is losing you now. In the name of the Lord, come on, tell what the Lord has done. Type that message and tell the world what the Lord has done. Let the world know that the Lord is able. If he did it then, he can do it now. Give him the praise. If he brought down a lion, if he brought down a bear, even this Goliath is coming down. I says coming down, this Goliath of poverty
This Goliath of lack, this Goliath of begging is coming down now in the name of Jesus. Come on, tell the world what the Lord has done. Come on, tell the world what the Lord has done. The Lord is mighty. Come on, hallelujah. The Lord is mighty. Come on, praise the Lord. The Lord is mighty. The Lord is awesome. The Lord is gracious. The Lord is gracious. The Lord has the power. The Lord can make a way where there is supposed to be no way. The Lord can make a way. Come on and tell what the Lord has done. Come on and tell what the Lord has done. He is mighty. He is mighty. Our God is mighty. Our God is mighty. Lord, we are telling about your works. We are telling about your mighty. We are telling in the world about your healing. Our God does never fail. He has anointed my head. My cup overrunneth. Surely goodness and mercy shall follow me. No evil shall follow me. No calamity is gonna follow me. No oppression shall follow me. No disease will follow me. No illness will follow me. No tragedy will follow me. No demotion will follow me. No frustration will follow me. No tears will follow me. All the tears of misery, they are drying now. I said they are drying now. I can see the hand of God drying out tears. Drying out tears, that tears of pain, that tears of pain, it is drying now. I said it is drying now in the name of Jesus. Receive the power to dry those tears. You're not going to cry again the tears of pain. You're not going to cry again the tears of disappointment. You're not going to cry again the tears of losses. You're not going to cry again the tears of a surgery. You're not going to cry again the tears of illness. You're not going to cry again. I declare today that every tear you are going to shed shall be the tears of joy, shall be the tears of laughter, shall be the tears of laughter. Your enemies are coming down in the name of Jesus. They are not going to prevail. I declare today, your enemies in Jesus' name, they are not going to prevail. I am here now in the presence of God, and I declare your enemies are not prevailing. I say your enemies are not prevailing. As you use your hands to invite other people, you are doing it in secret. You're using your hands to click like. You're using your hands to share this message. You're inviting your neighbor. You're inviting your friends. You're posting it on your wall. You are letting other people know about what the Lord has done. Let the world know that the Lord loves you. Let the world know that he will never leave you nor forsake you. Let the world know that the Lord our God, he does neither slumber nor sleepeth. Let the world know that he's going to get you out of this. He's going to get you out of this. I declare today, you are coming out of this, and you are coming out alive. You are coming out stronger. You are coming out better. You are coming out more focused. You are coming out more anointed. I sense an anointing coming upon you now in the name of Jesus. The anointing of laughter, the anointing of joy, because it is written in a book of Psalm, because you have loved righteousness and hated wickedness, therefore the Lord your God hath anointed you with the oil of gladness above your fellows. This is what I see when your fellows are crying, when your fellows are mourning, when your fellows don't know what to do, when your fellows don't know where to go. The Lord is lifting you. Come on, the Lord is taking you high. Come on, the Lord is raising a standard for you. Every time the enemy shall come like a flood, the Holy Spirit shall raise up a standard against him. I see a standard being raised against that devil. I can see a standard of God, a standard of God. You are raising above that storm. Come on, you're not going to sink. You're not going to die there in the name of Jesus. You are going higher. You're going above. You're going to smile. You're going to rejoice. That devil is broken. That devil is gone. That devil is gone. I said beneath your feet, you are not going low. You are not going low. You are more than low. You stronger than your enemy. You're stronger than your adversary. You are stronger than that pain. You are stronger than that death. You are stronger than that devil. Greater is he that is in you than the devil that is in the world. Come on, raise up your hands and tell the wonderful works that God has done for you. Tell that testimony. Come on, tell that testimony. Let the world know that God will do it again. Let the world know that you are not a defeated army of God. Let the world know that the church is raising up. I say it is raising up in power. All those who chased you away shall receive you again. I say everybody who diminished you, everybody who mocked you, everybody who laughed at you, everybody who looked down upon you, everybody who looked down upon you, they are going to return and say sorry to you because of what the Lord have done. Come on, I say hallelujah. Come on, hallelujah. And the Bible declares in the book of Exodus chapter 14 and verse 13, and when Moses said to the people, fear not, I also said to you now, fear not. I also said to you now, do not be afraid. That devil that was causing you to fear, I defeat it now. I defeat that devil that was causing you to tremble. I defeat that debt that was causing you to tremble. I defeat that sickness. Receive the power to be healed now. I defeat that illness that was causing you to tremble. I receive that the spirit of bachelet that was causing you to fear, the spirit of bachelet that was saying into your ears that you're not going to marry, that you expired, you've gone old, that your time is up. I defeated that devil in the name of Jesus. I say defeated that devil. You shall marry. I say you shall marry. I pray for you to get the favor of God. I pray for you, the spirit of the devil that has been whispering into your ears that you are expired, you'll never get married, that every man that comes to you leaves you in bitterness, leaves you disappointed. Every woman comes to your life, leaves you disappointed. I rebuke that spirit. I say rebuke that spirit. Go in the name of Jesus. Go in the name of Jesus. And Moses said to the Israelites, do not fear. Moses said to the people, as I said to you now, do not fear. Do not fear. Though you are surrounded, do not fear. Though you are bombarded, do not fear. Though everything is against you, do not fear. Though all the circumstances seem to be negatively opposing you, do not fear. Though your relatives may leave you, though your father and your mother may leave you, my God will raise you up. Do not fear. Though your pals, though your colleagues have deserted you, that says the Lord to you, do not fear. Though your body seem to be fading now, do not fear. Though the doctor has given you a bad report, do not fear. Though your bank manager, the loans manager has given you a bad report, that says the Lord to you, do not fear. Do not fear. Do not fear. I say it again, do not fear. Do not fear in the name of Jesus. Agatha, do not fear. I said do not fear in the name of the Lord. Do not fear, Maureen. I said do not fear in the name of Jesus. Kigwathi, do not fear in the name of the Lord. Maslinda, do not fear in the name of Jesus. Brenda, do not fear in the name of the Lord. I said do not fear. Do not fear. And Moses said to the people, which I said to you now, though you are bombarded, though you are surrounded, though you are grounded, though you are being threatened to be taken to jail, do not fear. Don't. The magistrate is not for you. Do not fear. Although they have hired lawyers to fight you, do not fear. Though the policeman with a gun is against you, do not fear. Though the Pope is against you, do not fear. Though the king is against you, do not fear. Though your relatives rise against you, that says the Lord to you, do not fear. They may be looking stronger, but in the physical, but greater greater is he that is in you than he that called, than he that is against you. The power of God is mightier, which is at work in you, which can make a way for you. And I declare to you now, do not fear, do not fear. My sister, do not fear. My brother, do not fear. My pastor, do not fear. Prophet of God, do not fear. Apostle, do not fear. Evangelist, do not fear. Come on, do not fear. Raise up your hands and worship God in this moment. Declare to yourself, I am not afraid. Declare to yourself, I am going forward. Declare to yourself, my God is with me as a mighty and terrible one. Therefore, my persecutors shall tremble. They shall not prevail. They shall be greatly ashamed, and their everlasting confusion shall never come to an end. Do not fear. Moses said to the people whom they were being, those that were being pursued by the Egyptians, by the chariots, by the and its riders, those that were pursued by the Egyptians, by the pharaohs of Egypt, by the horsemen. Yes, they were being pursued, but Moses said, though you don't know how to swim and the Red Sea is ahead of you, do not fear. Though you see the chariots, do not fear. Though you see the horse and the horsemen and the riders, do not fear. Though you see them carrying weaponries of war coming to destroy you, do not fear. Come on, do not fear. I don't know whom I'm talking to now, but this is what the Lord says. Don't the doctors have given you bad report. Do not fear. At this prophet prayer moment, I declare today, do not fear, do not fear, do not fear. God is intervening. God is coming in your situation. Do not fear. God is healing your body. Do not fear. God is reintroducing you to those people that chased you like a dog. Do not fear. In the name of Jesus, God is renewing your papers. He's granting you your visas. God is giving you that work permit. God is taking you to a better place. God is giving you favor before your bosses. God is giving you favor in that house of bondage. God is giving you favor. Do not fear. This is what the Lord says to me, that I should tell you, do not fear. I don't know who I'm talking to. You may be black or white. You may be Asian or in between. Yes, but do not fear. The power of God is upon you now. I feel an anointing of God joining me right now to declare to you, do not fear. Tell what the Lord has done. Testify about to the Lord how he killed a bear, how he killed a lion by your hand, and is going to take this Goliath away. Do not fear. The Lord who took you from Egypt and brought you here is not a poor general. He can lead you all the way forward. The God who called you is faithful. He can take you further. I see the anointing is taking you further. I can see the grace of God is taking you further. This is what the Lord saith. Do not fear, my friend. I said, do not fear, my friend. That leg is not going to be cut off. I said that leg of yours shall not be cut off because of the paralysis. That breast of yours is not going to be cut off due to cancer in the name of Jesus. Don't fear that cancer. There is the power of God that is at work in you. Don't fear that weakness. I said, do not fear. In the name of Jesus, do not fear. I declare today, do not fear. That leg of yours shall not be taken cut off by a cancer. In the name of Jesus, cancer, I command you, die now. I said, die now. There is the power of God. I said, there is power. I said, there is power. The power of God is healing you now. The power of God is intervening now. I said, is intervening now. Receive the power. Receive the power. I said, receive the. May you receive the power. The power to be healed. The power to be liberated. Do not fear. There is every circumstance that is causing you to fear. But hear the word of the Lord. Do not fear. Do not fear. Stand firm and see the salvation of the Lord. Come on, stand firm. Oh my God. Just Just stand firm and see what the Lord is going to do. Just stand firm and see the power of God. Just stand firm and see the deliverance of the Father. Just stand firm. Just stand firm and see the deliverance of the Lord. You're going to see the salvation of the Lord. You are not going to be deported. You're going to see the deliverance of the Lord. God is going to repellent you. God is going to repellent you. I said God is going to shine his favor upon you. God is going to take you through this. If he has taken you through that, he's taking you out of this. In the name of Jesus, the Bible declares, which he will work for you today is not going to take long. Whatever God can do, he can do it today. If God would do it yesterday, he can do it today. If God can finish it yesterday, he can finish it today. Our God is a God of now. Our God is a God of action. Our God is a God of order. Our God is a God of war. Our God is a mighty God. Our God is Jehovah Jireh. Our God is El Shaddai, who is more than enough. He says he will provide. He will provide every need according to his riches in glory by Christ Jesus. The Lord will provide. Our God is Jehovah Shammah, ever present. Our God is there. Where? Our God is there. He is there with you and is here with me. Our God is there. There to deliver you. Our God is there. There to heal you. Our God is there. There to bring you luck. Our God is there. There to bless you. Our God is there. There to favor you. Our God is there. There to defeat that enemy for you. Our God is there. There to heal that sickness in your body. Our God is there to take away that demon in your house. Those demons that are sleeping in dreams, God is taking them away. Those dreams which you dream at night, you are dreaming walking, you are dream walking. I break those dreams. I break their holds on you now in the name of Jesus. Every man, every woman who took your name into a shrine and put it in a boat, every day they are calling your name in the shrines. They have sacrificed blood and covered your name. I render it powerless in the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus, I declare today by fire. I declare today by fire in Jesus' mighty name. In Jesus' mighty name, let the glory of God deliver you today. Let the glory of God anoint you today. Let the glory of God bless you today. I can sense power. I can sense glory. I can says lifting in the name of the Lord. And the Bible declares, oh, and the Bible declares, come on, and the Bible declares, let me tell you, saint, the Bible declares that salvation of the Lord shall be seen today. And that's what I'm praying for now. Let the salvation of God be seen today. I am praying for the salvation of your children now in the name of Jesus. That vagabonding son of yours, I pray that he may return home in Jesus' mighty name. Even I'm praying for you, your legs, I'm praying for them. Let them be healed now in Jesus' mighty name. I say in Jesus' mighty name, come on, raise up your hands. Give God the glory. I said, give God the glory and he shall give you victory. I said, give God the glory. I said, give God the glory now. I said, give God the glory. The one who was, the one who is, and the one who is to come. The one who works miracles for us. The one who opens and no one can close. The one who has the keys of David. The scriptures in his hand. Yes, give him thanks. Give him glory. Declare the mighty works of God. Let the people know what the Lord has done for you. Come on, rejoice. You're not going under. The Bible declares the salvation of the Lord shall be seen today. You're going to go back to the doctor, and the doctor shall give you a good report that you are healed, that you are repellated, that illness, that disease, that virus is no longer in your body, is no longer in your blood. In the name of Jesus, I declare to your lungs freedom in Jesus' Jesus' name, I declare to your legs freedom in Jesus' name. I declare to your head freedom in Jesus' name. I declare to your chest freedom in Jesus' name. I declare to your bones freedom, freedom, freedom. Be free now. I said, be free now. I said, be free now in the name of Jesus. I said, be free now. Somebody, you are setting loose. Somebody, God is delivering you. God is delivering you from the problem in your intestines in the name of Jesus. The stomach constipation is healing now in the name of Jesus. Yes, it has brought you trouble, but stand firm and see the salvation of the Lord, which is doing for you. Not tomorrow, not the day after tomorrow, in this very hour, this very prophetic hour, this very prophetic hour in the name of Jesus, in this hour of prophecy, in Jesus' name. God is doing it now as you share, as you type like. God is doing it now. God is paying that loan as you share and like. God is typing. God is typing your miracle now in the name of Jesus. Your miracle is being typed. I say your miracle is being typed now in the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus, that man is going to marry you. Don't run away in the mighty name of Jesus. Leah, don't run away in the name of Jesus. God is making a way where there's supposed to be no way. In that the Bible declares, and God saw that Leah was hated and opened her womb, and the womb of Rachel was closed. God knows what you have been through. I said, God knows whatever you've been through, but God is opening your ways. God is opening your doors. God is closing down the doors of your enemies in the name of Jesus. The Bible declares, for the Egyptians whom you see today, you shall see them no more. I want to declare now, those Egyptians you're seeing now, those persecutors you're seeing now, those people that are criticizing you now, those people that are minimizing you now, you shall see them no more. The Lord will fight for you, and you have only to be silent. You have only to hold your peace. I want to say to you now, hold your peace, brother. God is in this thing. Hold your peace, sister. God is fighting for you. I say, God is fighting for you. Just hold your peace. I can see trouble is ending. I can see trouble is ending. I can see tears are ending. I can see the Lord is seizing that trouble. The Lord is seizing that mouth that was shouting at you in the name of Jesus. Every mouth that was shouting at you, God is stopping it now in the name of Jesus. They have been shouting and saying, where is your God? They have been shouting and saying, where is the God of the Bible you've been carrying every day? They've been shouting and saying, now where is the God of the church? They've been shouting and saying, where is the God you pray for every day? You've been shouting and saying, where is the God you plant seeds of faith every day? Where is that God now? The time has come for you to be quiet and let them be silenced in the name of Jesus. You don't need to fight in this battle. Just stand still and see the salvation of the Lord. I can see it coming now in the name of Jesus. You are being liberated from that loan. You are being liberated. Your house is not being taken. Your child is not dying. No, your child is not dying. I command the spirit of death that has bombarded your child to die that a natural death in the name of Jesus. That spirit of death, that spirit of illness, to die with a natural death in the name of Jesus. I command that death to die in Jesus' mighty name. That enemy that has been shouting, that enemy in the chariot, let the Lord disable them. Let the Lord disable their chariot in the name of Jesus. Let the Lord reduce your enemy's speed in the mighty name of the Lord. I declare today, I say declare today, I say declare today, by the power of the Holy Spirit, the Bible declares, the word of God, the blood and the water would agree on earth. Yes, in the name of the Lord, as God the Father, God the Son, and God the Holy Spirit do agree now. I stand in that covenant, I break every powers of the enemy. I break their speed. I slow them down. Every demon that was pursuing you, I slow it down in the name of Jesus. That demon of stagnation, lack of progress, that was chasing you down and saying, as it happened to your mother, it is going to happen to you. I rebuke it now. No, 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 no. It's not going to happen to you. I am a man of God. I stand in his presence and I stand to declare, what failed your mother will not fail you. I say, what failed your father will not fail you. What your father couldn't do in years, you're going to do it in days. I declare that to you now. What failed your uncle, you shall do it to you. What failed your auntie, you will accomplish it now in the name of Jesus. Fear thou not. The God you serve, he is able, more than able, to do exceedingly abundantly, above, beyond what you can think or even ask. Oh, hallelujah. Ramaka tereboko tereboko. There is somebody I'm praying for. God is rescuing you from the eyesight problem. Now receive your healing. The God you serve, he is able to take the pain away in the name of Jesus. You had been scheduled for operation, but the Lord is healing you from the intestine problem in the name of the Lord. You have got hearing problem. I command your hearing problem to be healed now in the name of Jesus. Somebody who are bewitched. Somebody who are bewitched. You feel you have pain in your legs. Too much pain. Too much heat. Like fire in your feet. But I command it now. Be healed now in the name of Jesus. I say, be healed now. Receive the power. I say, receive the power. The power of the Holy Spirit. The power of God is healing you now. I can see somebody. Your chest is healing now. Completely, and also your chest is being healed. I can see money. The tears you are going to cry next will be tears of joy. Carrying shelves of joy. In the name of the Lord. Those that sowed in tears. Those that went out carrying seeds in tears. Carrying seeds while weeping, they shall return carrying shelves of joy. Get ready, you are about to reap. Get ready, a payday has come. Get ready, I can hear voice saying to me, a payday has come. You have sowed many days, but it's like your things are dying. Every time you sow, your seeds are dying. But let me tell you this. Unless a seed falleth in the ground and dies, it cannot bear fruits. Your seed looks to be dead. Your investment looks to be dead. Your job looks to be dead. Your marriage looks to be dead. Your work looks to be dead. The house you are in looks to be dead. Your children looks to be dead. Your marriage looks to be dead. Your spouse looks to be dead. Everything around you looks to be dead. But I declare today, arise has come. Arise has come. You're going to rejoice. I say you're going to rejoice again. I say you're going to rejoice again. If I be a man of God, if I am anointed of God in this prophetic moment, if I'm anointed by God, if I am anointed by God, oh Rabaka Terevoko, you are raising again. I say you are raising again. Receive the power to raise you again. I say receive the power to raise you again. There is an anointing coming to you. There is power coming to you. I say there is glory coming to you. You're being reinstated in your glory. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. I declare favor with your boss now. Somebody are going to be paid twice. Twice you're going to be paid in the name of the Lord. They have disturbed you. They have minimized you. They have abused you. You are feeling so rotten. You are feeling so low. You are feeling so depressed. You are feeling alone. You are feeling isolated. But you are going to be paid twice of your salary in the name of Jesus. I don't know who I'm talking to, but you're going to be paid twice of your salary. If I be a man of God and I stand in his presence, may that come to pass. If I be a man of God and I stand in his presence, may you be healed in the name of Jesus. And Moses said to the Israelites, why do you cry? Oh my God. The Lord said to Moses, why do you cry to me? Why do you cry to me. Tell the people of Israel to move forward. Tell the people of Israel to go forward. This is what the Lord says. You is stagnant. Do you is depressed? Do you is oppressed? Do you is confused? Do you is confounded? Do you doesn't know what to do and where to get your situation? It is time to move forward. It is time to go forward. But you may tell me, but pastor, there is no way I can go forward. Behind me there are chariots of Pharaoh and horsemen and their riders, and ahead of me there is the Red Sea. I will say, yeah, pastor, I will go forward. This is what the Lord says. He can make a way. I say he can make a way where there seems to be no way. And the Lord said to Moses, tell these people to go forward. You may be seeming low, you may be, the way may be seeming slippery, but thus says the Lord, may you move forward and let your enemy's feet become slippery, let your enemy's way become darker and slippery. Let the angel of God pursue them now in the name of Jesus. Everything that was planning to bring you down, that was planning to bring you low, may the Lord bring it low in the name of Jesus. Let their way become darker. Let their way become slippery. Let their way. Let sudden destruction fall upon them that were pursuing you without a cause. Let sudden failure fall upon them that were raising against you without any cause. Let that very pit which they had dug for your feet, themselves fall into it in the name of Jesus. I am praying as a man of God. I am praying as a man of God. Let the anointing of God move you forward. And Moses said to the Israelites, go forward, go forward. I also said to you, you are moving forward. You are not returning. You are not getting deported. You are moving forward. You're getting that job in the name of Jesus. I say you're getting that job in the name of Jesus. You're getting that permanent residence in the name of Jesus. That married man is going to marry you. You're going to marry in the name of Jesus. Because I see you moving forward. I see the Lord establishing you. I see the Lord favoring you. I see the Lord anointing you. I see the Lord strengthening you. I see the Lord giving you back whatever you lost to the devil. I see the Lord is giving to you that which you went to look for. The Lord is giving you money. I say the Lord is giving you money. I say the Lord is bringing that money in the name of the Lord. And the Lord said to Moses, but as for you, lift up your staff and stretch out your hand over the sea and divide it, that the people of Israel may go through the sea on dry land. God can perform two miracles at a go. God can perform, listen to me, children of God, God can perform two miracles at a go. God can perform two miracles at a go. And verse 17 declares of chapter 14 Exodus, thou will harden the heart of the Egyptians so that they shall go in after them. Thou will get glory over Pharaoh and over his host and his chariot and his horsemen. Listen to me, child of God. God told Moses to lift up his hand, to lift up his staff and divide the sea so that the people may cross over. When Moses lifted up his staff, he divided the sea. The people of God were able to cross over. The people of God were able to cross over. The people of God, God performed the two miracles at the same time. He divided the sea and he raised it up that they may walk on the dry land. He leveled the sea. He divided and leveled it. There was no potholes in the sea. He had to level it. God is going to level your miracle for you. God is going to level your miracle for you. You're going to walk where other people failed to walk. You shall walk where other people failed. They reached and failed. They reached and gave up. God is going to take you forward. I say our God shall take you forward. I say in the name of the Lord, our God shall take you forward. I can see a man. You are sitting in your house. You are so confused. You don't know what next. You feel like hanging yourself. You feel like dying. You feel like dying and nobody will realize. You feel like dying and don't become a problem to anybody. But my friend, you are not dying soon. The Lord is raising you to a level of your miracle. The Lord is doing it now. The Lord is answering that prayer. The Lord is doing it today. Just what do you have in your hand? You can use it to divide your sea. You can use that staff. You can use that idea. You can use that knowledge. You can use that connection. Pick up your phone and call that somebody. Tell them what you are going through. God is making a way in the name of Jesus. You've gotten a list of problems. You've got a list of problems, but you are wiser. You are intellect. You have connections, but you want to give up now. My friend, you've come too far to give up. You have come too far to lose heart. You have come too far just to quit. Quitters never win, and winners never quit. It is no time to complain. It is no time to grumble. It is no time to murmur. It is no time to think of going back. It is time to move on. My God, it's time to move on. I am speaking to you. The time has come for you to reap. The time has come. I can see the Lord is getting you connected. God is raising a Silas for you. God is raising a Silas for you who is going to help you without a cost. You're going to remember these words that Pastor Emmanuel Binaisa, when he was at the prophet prayer moment, he declared these words to me. He declared these words: God is going to raise a Silas for you who is going to help you to make this happen without any cost. They are just going to favor you. They are just going to help you. They are just going to open that door for you. I declare it now, not very far from now, in the name of Jesus. This remaining months of the year, you're going to rejoice. I say you're going to rejoice. I say you're going to rejoice in the name of Jesus. You're going to rejoice. You're going to get that money. You're going to win that tender. God is going before you in the name of Jesus. There is a woman watching me now. There is a demon which come every night and have sex with you and have sex with you, but you are tired. You are tired. You are tired of it. And as a result, every relationship you get in, it gets broken and unawares. It gets broken miscellaneously. But I am praying. I break that demon. I command it now. Out of you now. I say out of you now. And I'm speaking favor. I'm speaking release. I'm speaking freedom. In the name of the Lord. The Bible declares, God told Moses, what you have in your hands, you can use it to divide the sea. But even if you divide it, I know Pharaoh, I know his men, I know the Egyptians will not settle. They want to pursue after you. They want to see you defeated. They want to see you go low. They want to see you giving up. They want to see you in tears. They want to see your case being defeated in court. They want to see you in shame. They want to see you in cowardice. They want to see you in fear. They want to see you in tears. They want to see you mourning. They want to see you in regret. But in the name of Jesus, the Bible declares, I know what Pharaoh wants, but my plans for you are good plans. God has a good plan for you. He has a better plan. He has a better plan. He has a future for you. He has a hope for you. That Pharaoh will not win. I said that Pharaoh that is pursuing you, that Pharaoh Pharaoh that wants you defeated, that Pharaoh that wants you dead, he's not going to win. I declare today, he's not going to win. Receive the power, receive the anointing, receive the grace. That Pharaoh will not win. If I'm anointed today, if I am anointed today, that Pharaoh must not win. In the name of the Lord. And the Lord is saying, but I know the Egyptians. I know the Egyptians. I know how they think. They shall know that I am the Lord. They shall know that I am the Lord. Your family members are going to know that you have a big God in the name of Jesus. Your colleagues are about to realize there is a God you serve in the name of Jesus. I declare today your spouse is about to know that you've got a big God. This is what I declare in the name of Jesus. The world is about to know that you have a big God in that Arabic country where you are, in that Asian country, in that United States of America. They're about to realize that you've got a big God in that Canada. They're about to realize that you have a big God in Europe. They're about to realize that you have a big God in Great Britain. They are going to realize that you have a big God in Africa, Sub-Sahara Desert. They are going to realize that you have a big God in my country, Uganda. They are about to realize that you have a big God. The Bible declares, and the Egyptians shall know. Though they thought they tended to be powerful, they thought they are greater, but they are about to know that there is a man, there is a woman who has a big God. Your God will not let you be ashamed. He's not going to let you walk away in cowardice. He's not going to let you walk away in fear. You are not going to be ashamed. And the Egyptians will know that, oh, I am the Lord, and now I have gotten glory over Pharaoh and his chariots and his horsemen. Oh my God, God is going to get glory over your family. They are going to know God has glory in the name of Jesus. God is about to introduce you. Oh, 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 God is about to introduce you. God is about to bring them to bow. God is about to speak for you. God is about to anoint you even in a high way. God says into my ears now, is raising a generation, an anointed one, an anointed generation, an anointed army, and you are being enlisted among this army. You're going to win. You're going to give glory to God. They are going to know that your God is mighty. They are going to know that your God has power. And in verse 24 of Exodus 14, the Bible declares that in the morning watch, hallelujah, in the morning watch, the Lord in the morning watch, the Lord in the pillar of fire and in the cloud down on the Egyptian forces and drew the Egyptian forces into a panic. I am praying now, may the Lord draw your enemies into a panic. Those that were watching you fall, may they watch you in a panic when you are rising up rapidly, when you are rising up in a way they never expected. Those who are counted you out and given you days to die, let them watch you in a panic in the name of Jesus. They that said your children are not going to make it, let them start watching your children, but in a panic. Let God cause panic in the camps of your enemy in the name of Jesus. I declare today the Lord is causing a panic in the hearts of your children, in the hearts of those that were hating you, in the hearts of those that disliked you, in the hearts of those who said nothing good can come out of you. The Lord is causing a panic in the camp of your enemies. The Lord is causing a panic in the camp of your enemies. In the name of Jesus, clogging their chariot wheels so that they drove heavily in Jesus' name. Oh my God. And Egyptians said, let us flee from before Israel, for the Lord fights for them against the Egyptians. I am praying, let your enemy realize that God is fighting for you. I am praying today, my friend. I am praying today, my sister. I am praying today, my brother. Let the world know that God is fighting for you. And they said, let us flee from the face of Israel, because their God is fighting for you. God made their chariots heavy. I am praying, may the Lord reduce the speed of those that are pursuing you. Let him do it now, in the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus, Morgan, I am praying for you. May God put a panic in the hearts of people that were pursuing you. In the name of Jesus, those that didn't want to make it happen for you, those that wanted you to be deported, I am praying for you. Let God throw a panic into them. In the name of Jesus, I say, Morgan, receive the favor of God. You are created to be loved. You are created to be celebrated, not to be tolerated. In the name of Jesus, as you share this message, may God share your name in the hearts of people that are meant to love you, that are meant to lift you. In the name of the Lord, I say, as you share this message, as you share this message, may the Lord God, I say, may the Lord God bring people in your life that are going to leave you changed. They are going to leave you happy. I can see money coming your way. God is giving you enough to eat. My father, I am praying right now. There is somebody in a dilemma. They only need something to eat. The Bible declares that God gives food to the eater. I am praying for you now. May God give you food you eat, and may God give you seeds to sow. This is what I'm praying now, in the name of Jesus. May God give you food to eat. It is happening now. It is happening now. It is happening now. Your children will not starve. Your children will not beg for bread. You are the children of Papa. You are children of God. Father God, I am praying. Let God of glory, let God cause your enemies to panic. I can see your enemies are panicking. I can see, starting from today, your enemies are starting to panic. Those who wanted you to come down, they are starting to panic at the way you are rising. In the name of Jesus, they are panicking now at the way you are being favored. They are panicking now at the way you are being connected. They are panicking now at the way you are receiving double, in the name of the Lord, because the Bible declares God shall give you double for your trouble. Their speed is being lowered. Their speed is being lowered, in the name of Jesus. Their speed is being lowered, but your rising up is so rapid that they are panicking. In the name of Jesus, the way you talk to people is causing them to panic. The way you smile is going to start causing them to panic. The way you earn is causing them to panic. The way you connect with your spirit shall cause them to panic. The way you connect your husband will cause them to panic. The way you connect to your bosses shall make them to panic. I can see your enemies now. They are starting to panic. I said they are starting to panic. They are starting to panic. They are starting to panic. This is what I am praying. The way you are receiving favor, favor after favor, increase after increase, mercy after mercy, grace after grace, healing after healing, connection after connection, provision after provision, healing after healing. It is causing your enemy, those that have been bewitching you, those that have been praying bad prayers against you, those that have been making bad confessions against you, the Lord is throwing a panic. I say the Lord, my God, is throwing a panic into them now, in the name of Jesus. You are about to make your co-wife tremble. You are about to make your co-wife tremble, in the name of the Lord. They are going to see you and the way you connect with your loved one. They are going to panic. This is what I am praying for. Somebody who somewhere, you are causing her to tremble. That happens to you now. I said that happens to you now. I can hear power joining you now.
I can hear glory joining you now. I can hear anointing joining you now. Come on, let us tell about the wonderful works which God has done. Share your testimony now. Tell me what the Lord has done. Tell me what the Lord is doing in the name of Jesus. Can I say something to you as I wind up? You are not going down. The power of God is raising you up. The anointing of the Holy Spirit. You've been anointed with fresh oil. They are God's fresh oil. They are God's fresh anointing. They are God's healing now. They are God's reparation now. Receive it now in the name of Jesus. They are God's mercy in the name of the Lord. They are God's fresh connection. There comes fresh ideas in the name of the Lord. The Bible declares in the book of Deuteronomy, chapter 8 and verse 18, you shall also remember the Lord your God, for it is He who giveth thee the power to get wealth. I am praying for you wherever you are. May God bombard His power upon you, the power to get wealth, the power to earn money, the power to get connection, the power to be lifted, the power to be lifted by the power of the Holy Spirit. I can see you being taken high. I can see you being blessed. I can see you walking in power. I can see you walking in grace. I can see you walking in glory in the name of the Lord. In the name of the Lord, I can see the Lord lifting you. The Lord is taking you high. I can see the Lord is taking you high. Somebody, you are watching me. The Lord is taking away that shame. Somebody, you are watching me now. God is taking away that pain. Somebody is watching me now. Your sun will not set earlier than it was supposed to. I mean, you're not going to die earlier in the name of the Lord. You're not going to die earlier. This is what I'm seeing now. The spirit of death is breaking now. Evelyn, Evelyn, the spirit of death is breaking in the name of Jesus. Marvin, the spirit of death is breaking. Sanyu, the spirit is breaking in the name of the Lord. Wherever you are, Chomukama, you are being loosed in the name of Jesus. Rutendo, you are being loosed. Tendo, you are being loosed. Receive the power of God. Purity, you are being loosed. Makena, you are being loosed by the power of the living God in the name of the Lord. Let the power lose you. Mama Ngosh, God is losing you now. Wherever you are, God is losing you now. God is establishing you now in the name of Jesus. I say God is establishing you now. I can sense favor. I can sense power. I can sense anointing. I can sense anointing. I can sense glory. I can sense glory. I can see a garment of praise being put upon you. The spirit of the Lord God is upon me, because He hath anointed me. He hath anointed me, the Lord my God. I am anointed to declare liberty to the captives. I am anointed to set free the captives now. I am anointed to declare the year of the Lord's favor. I am anointed to open the doors of the prison to them that are bound. I am anointed now in the name of the Lord to heal the brokenhearted. Every heart that is broken, I am praying now, may you be healed. I am praying now, let God bind up that heart. Let God heal that heart right now in His presence, right now under the glory, right now under the anointing. Let God heal that heart. I am praying now, let your heart be healed. I say, let your heart be healed in Jesus' name. The pain go from your heart. Somebody, you have a hole on your heart, it's being healed now. You got tumors in your stomach, it's being healed now in the name. It has been paining you, your umbilical cord has been paining you for longer, but receive the power to be healed now in the name of Jesus. You have swollen wounds on your private parts, but I am praying now, let the Lord heal you now. I say, let the Lord heal you now by the power of the Holy Spirit. I am praying for total healing. I am praying for total recovery. I am praying for pain to go in the name of Jesus. I say, I am praying for pain. Go right now. I said, go right now. I said, go right now. In the name of Jesus. I say, in the name of Jesus. I pray for breakthrough. I pray for breakthrough. You are watching me now. God is taking you higher. He's throwing your enemies in panic. In the name of the Lord. And in verses 30, chapter 14 of Exodus, the Bible declares, thus the Lord saved Israel that day from the hand of the Egyptians, and Israel saw the Egyptians dead on the seashores. You're going to see your enemies disappearing. You're going to see shame holding them. You're going to see them being driven backward. Everybody who was wishing you evil, everyone who was wishing you tragedy, everyone who was wishing you bad luck, you're going to see them being driven backward. If I be a man of God and standing in the place of prayer at this prophetic hour moment, I am praying, let the Lord of grace crush that devil. Let the God of grace crush that demon. Let the God of grace crush that weakness in the name of Jesus. Israel saw the great power that the Lord used against the Egyptians. So the people feared the Lord, and they believed in the Lord and in his servant Moses. This is going to drive you to believe God more. This is going to bring your family together. It's going to reunite your family. I am praying for a miracle in your house that is going to bring your family together. I am praying for a miracle in your house that is going to bring your children together. I am praying for a miracle in your house that is going to bring people from afar to come and testify, to come and witness, to come and see what the Lord hath done. May it happen now. I say, may it happen now. If I be anointed, if I'm a man of God, I declare and decree, a miracle come your way. A miracle come your way. May it come your way now. In the name of the Lord, it is happening now. The favor is coming that is going to leave everybody shattered and bombarded. It's going to leave your enemies in panic, and you're going to see that God is alive. May God perform it now, that they may see that God is alive. That God is alive. In the name of the Lord, receive power to be raised, receive power to be increased, receive power to be healed, receive power to be anointed. In the name of Jesus, as you prepare to give your gift to this ministry, as you prepare to give your offering, as you prepare to give your seed of faith, as you prepare to give your tithe, I am praying now. The Bible declares, bring here the full tithe in the house of God and your offering, that there may be food in my house, and now and test ye me with it, and see whether or not open the floodgates of heaven, whether or not open the windows of heaven, and I will pour out on you blessing, and it will not have enough room, it will not have enough space to contain it. I will rebuke the devourer for you. I will rebuke the devourer for you. Let it happen now. Let the devourer be rebuked in the name of Jesus. As you prepare to give, yes, as you prepare to sow a seed, let the devourer be rebuked now. That devourer was set to devour your marriage, that devourer that was set to devour your money, that devourer that was set to devour your business, that devourer that was set to devour your salary, I rebuke him now in the name of Jesus. I shall rebuke him now in the name of Jesus. He shall not devour it in Jesus' mighty name. That devourer that comes every time in form of sickness, every time you get the money, you receive a phone call that your mother is sick. Every time you get salary, you receive a phone call that you have got a problem at home and your money is cannot buy for you. As you give money, as you give an offering, as you give a donation, let God give you what money cannot buy. Let God introduce you what money cannot introduce you. Let God uplift you where many cannot uplift you. Let God bless you. Let God keep you. Let God surround you. Let God protect you in the presence of your enemies. May God prepare a table for you. As it is written, that God prepares. God prepares a table for you in the presence of your enemies. May it happen now. I pray for that table. I pray for that table. You may be in a fallen land, but I am praying. May you come back with a blessing. May you come back with a connection. I can see a new connection coming your way. You wanted to leave the country and go to another country. I see it happening now in the name of Jesus. I see it happening now. Receive the power. Receive the glory. Receive the anointing. Receive the favor. Now it is happening. Now it is happening. Now it is happening. As you make preparation to sow a seed, our numbers are on the screen. As they go and go, you can prepare to sow a seed. You can give a one-time donation or even a monthly donation. Whatever God is touching you to give, please do it now. And we shall use it for the kingdom of God in the name of Jesus. Father, we bless you. Father, we worship you. Father, we worship you. You are so holy. You are so gracious. You are mighty King. You are a mighty King. You are a mighty King. Somebody, you are watching me. You are preparing to leave that house. Don't go. God has prepared a table for you in the presence of your enemies. Favor comes your way. Oh, Father, I give you praise. In Jesus' mighty name. My dear friend, I've come to the close of this live cast. Thank you for being with me at this prophetic. I know you are getting blessed. Please, God blesses you to become a blessing. God told Abraham, I'll bless you and I'll make you a blessing. God told me that as I bless the people that I don't know, God will bless the people that I know. As I make it happen for the people that are far off from me, that are not even my relatives, God will do it for the people that are so dear to me. You are dear to me, and I'm doing this for you. But as you also plant a seed in this ministry, it will help us reach out to the needy, reach out to the old, reach out to the lame. As you can see on the screen, we are having outreaches even during this lockdown to reach out to the lame, to give them food, to bless them with clothing, most especially give them food, because our nation has been put on another 42-day lockdown. So we need your assistance. We need your food. You can buy us a one bag of maize flour, sugar, rice, anything you can afford. And we are going to ensure that we feed these poor families. And as you do that, God will bless you. This is a situation. It's a situation we have all to get involved. We are all called to serve. We are all called to bless. We are all called to be partakers of God's grace by blessing others. So as you do this, God will bless you in return, and God will reward you. Pastor Emmanuel and Pastor Brenda Binaisa, before we go out, I'd like to lead you into this prayer of salvation. Say, Lord Jesus, I give you my life today. Forgive me of all my sins. Wash me from my transgressions and cleanse me. Remove my names from the book of judgment and write them
in the book of life. Henceforth I believe that Christ is the Lord of my life and is the Savior of my soul. That I confess it with my mouth that I am saved. Thank you, Lord, for loving me and for saving my life. Amen, amen, amen. Let us meet right here every Monday, Wednesday, and Friday, the same time at 8 p.m. East African time, to be here praying together, and the Lord will bless you in Jesus' name. So don't go away before you subscribe. Please do this. Subscribe. I need that subscription. Subscribe, like, share, comment, and declare what the Lord have done. Psalm 105. Declare the wonderful works of the Lord. Send us the testimony of what the Lord has done, and God will bless you. Amen and amen.